I'm going to resume the recording.
Hi, Roz.
Well,
you're on mute.
Me?
No, Roz.
Oh, Roz.
No, Roz, she's on mute.
Yeah.
You Roz. Can unmute yourself if you press the, but I think we like to keep everybody muted, right, Mike?
Right, yeah. So yesterday I saw Roz and Betty in the store. I had my mask on and I had my sunglasses on. And I walked up to them and I said, hi. And they look at me with this big blank stare, like, who the hell are you?
He looks so handsome, yeah? He looks so gorgeous.
Well, it was good to see you yesterday.
It was wonderful.
That I had sunglasses on too, so that wouldn't
No, we missed you last time.
Thank you. We'll still stick a Clift in the Home Depot.
Oh, what is that? A refrigerator, an ice box.
A Naya machine machen cult.
It is very nice. It was a
refrigerator, I think.
Gesunter buy.
Hi, Ann.
Hello there. Whoops, I'm trying to make this straight. Here we go.
Nice to see you.
Jetzt fällt Rennen, es ist so still, wo ist die?
Wo ist mir wart auf achte Seige?
Wo ist die Seige?
Es halb sich auf achte Seige, es ist noch nicht achte Seige.
I can speak Yiddish.
Hier, 3 minutes.
Was ist die Zeit nicht?
Es ist jetzt 5 minutes wie früher wie achte Seige.
7:57.
7:57, right.
for a minute.
Hey, Mike, we got another Roz on here.
That's right. Yeah.
That's my friend.
Oh, is my goodness.
Is
Hi, Tina.
Hi.
Is it Roz?
Hi, Tina. They're my cousins from the States.
Oh, that's nice.
Rosalind, who are you? Is your name Rosalind?
Well, Rosalind is a long form. But I usually call myself Roz.
I have an interesting story to tell you about this little girl.
Okay.
But maybe I'll save it till Mike what starts.
What is your Hebrew name?
Her name is Shoshana. Roz. Shoshana in Hebrew.
In Hebrew.
Yiddish.
She's not in Hebrew.
No, you don't have a Hebrew
name. My Hebrew name is Shoshana.
That's Rose. Okay.
Mine. We're from the same family. What do you want?
Mine is Rachel. But so Sean is a Rose.
So? Well, Rosalind.
Name Rose. She's a, that's Rose.
Now, I guess it was Sprinza and Shana. But I didn't like Sprinza.
I didn't get that one. You can forget that one.
Who's ringing?
Whoever, we all have to listen in now.
If
you don't mute when it rings, we all have to listen in.
That was a butt dial. I apologize. I was calling Susan.
That's cute, Tina. That's cute.
But it didn't.
My mother-in-law was Sprinza. I told her that it came from the Spanish Esperanza. Then she thought it was a beautiful name, Esperanza.
My mother's name was Sprinza Orchid. Right behind the Roger Rosalind.
Yes?
I swear, Rosie.
There's two Rosalinds, Rosalind.
Yes.
There's two Rosalind.
Let the other
one. You call me Roz to make it shorter.
His name is Sprinza. I wanted to tell my mother.
Okay, wait. I got to get you.
Oh, she's going to tell a story in a few minutes. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hi, Rosie. Hi,
my phone rang and it rings on this thing, so I got to turn it off.
His mother's name was Sprinza.
Hi, Miss Betty.
Hi, darling.
Hi,
how are you today?
Hey. Oh, Shirley, we got to get a date for you to come here. Mike and I, you and I are going to get it.
Sounds great.
We missed you yesterday.
I'm
going to
call you.
telling me the Zoom meeting started. So that
okay.
Whose mother's name was Sprinza?
No, nobody's.
My mother-in-law.
Yeah, my mother's name is Sprinza. What was her English name?
The Americans have heard quite
Francis.
Francis in Yiddish is Franya.
My mother-in-law was Franya. I don't know any more Rosalinds before the
We also had an Aunt Rose who was Rachel and not Shoshana.
Yes. Her name is Rachel.
My name is Rachel. But I spell Rosalyn, R-O-S-L-Y-N. Not Roseline and not Roslyn, whatever.
Did you unmute yourself?
Yeah, we did. Yeah,
it's good. Hi, Barb. Oh, you've got a few Torontonians on tonight, Mike.
Yeah. Hi, Edie.
You got a lively group on tonight.
We do.
That's because Joe.
Labedick.
All right. Labedick, well, right.
Good word, Shirley.
Hi, Michael. Joe's back in town.
There's Joe. Joe's
Edie. Hi, everybody.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Well, start. Thank you, everybody, for joining. Maybe there'll be a few more people coming on. I see a few popping up real quickly.
I don't have. It's not. It's really.
So let me ask you one.
I'm not muted, right?
I'd like everybody to mute themselves.
Hey, Rosie.
Everybody mute themselves, okay? So.
Want to mute? Okay, I'm muted.
And if you don't mute yourself and you get a phone call, then you have to share the phone call with everybody here. we all have to hear both ends of it. So, but keep muted.
I met all kind of people from Jacksonville at a shower this weekend that they're all know Anita.
Great. All right.
Nice. Was one Rhonda?
Well, I heard that Anita showers with a lot of people.
All right, let's get started. So just a couple ground rules. One is keep mute. Two is raise your hand if you want to talk. We'll call on everybody, and I've got this big screen that's got 48 or 49 people, so I should be able to see everybody. And if you can, where your name is, make sure it's your name. It doesn't say something iPad or something. Put your first and last name. And this way we record these and then we know who's here. And also in the chat, we'll be able to see who's there. So you just go up to those little dots on the upper right-hand corner of your screen. So I think that I want to start by introducing Esther Scheer. Esther's been with us for a number of sessions. Al Davis has some conflicts on Monday night, and he's been a partner with us, and he has first and third Monday, he has meetings that he needs to go to. And Esther has so graciously agreed to become a partner with us in leading this. The criteria for being a leader, there were about two or three of them. Number one was she's funny. Number two, she's funny. And number three, she's funny. And I guess number four, she's willing to do this.
Yes, that's number one.
So you know, I don't know if you could beat Al on being funny. I mean, Al's pretty funny, but Esther was very, very gracious to agree to partner with us. Shirley's going to help out whenever she can, and Joe is going to continue. So what I'd like to do is just start tonight by Esther just introducing yourself, a little bit about your background. And maybe you could talk about the story that we all fell out of our seat when we heard this story tonight.
Okay, my name is Esther, and I'm a Torontonian right now, and there's a few Torontonians on the screen. So Jerry, you're a Torontonian? Oh, I can't hear him. I didn't know he's a Torontonian.
I'm a Torontonian.
Oh, very good. So we've got about four or five people from Toronto on the screen. First of all, I want to thank very much Mike for offering me this position. It came out of nowhere. I'm just looking to enjoy myself, and he phoned me up to to come on board. So I said, sure, because if I can speak Yiddish, why not? Ich bin geboren in Schweden. Von meinen Eltern nach dem Mochumme sind gegangen in Schweden. Von den dänischen Countries sind gewesen sehr gut zu den Jiden nach dem Mochumme. Von Schweden, meine Mama und Tate umgenehmte Schiff bei Halifax, Nova Scotia. Und ist gekommen in Toronto. Anyhow, ich bin gegangen in a public school. Meine Brüder sind gegangen in a Yiddish school. Aber mein Tat hat gesagt, dass ein Mädel darf nicht haben, darf nicht wissen von das von der school. Anyways, meine Eltern haben geredet Yiddish in daheim und also habe ich geholfen zu reden Yiddish. Und ich habe sehr lieb zu reden und ich habe sehr lieb zu hören, andere Menschen reden, geht Jiddisch. Ich habe drei Kinder und ich habe keine Haare sechs eigentlich. Ich weiß, man tun nicht so, wie viele Kinder man hat. Man sucht mit Zeit Geld, mit Zeit nicht Kinder. So, ah. Ja. Es ist eine schwere Zeit jetzt, weil wir alle in derselben Schiff mit der Covid. Und hoffentlich hat man können herauskommen von das Lebendigkeit. Verstehst?
Ja.
So, ich habe gearbeitet in einer Company für 34 Jahre. Und das ist gewesen in Finn Kashrut. Und das ist der Kashrut Council of Canada. Habe ich gearbeitet dort in 34 Jahre. Aber ich habe sehr gesagt, Gitte stories to the Thailand, but ich miss the Thailand very sehr langsam, sehr slowly, and this is my story about was ist sehr gitte gelachter hampe Nacht ist Mike's Frau Shirley, sie hat sehr gut Yiddish mit noch der erste Mal ich bin herangekommen in dem Group, but Mike mich geschickt Pictures von Shirley's Eltern in Nuance Milan, nach dem Chumis, in der Sache gegangen in Italy. Und ich habe gehalten, sie kicken auf die Pictures, und ich sagte mich, der Mann von den Pictures, was ich habe von mein Mann ist unfortunately late nicht jetzt. Anyways, mein Mann ist mit Spuche, dem Eltern, umgegangen in Milan, same place. Und ich habe gesagt, Fotos von my husband's parents, wo sie dann in Wasser sind geschwimmen und gehabt haben sehr gut time. So I think, as Shirley and ich sind in Landsleit. I have a feeling, dass sie, für die ihre Eltern sind gegangen in Cyprus and also Zeb's parents sind gegangen in Cyprus and sind gewesen in Yisrael and Zeb's parents sind gewesen in Yisrael. Ich meine, als Miss Landsleidies, Shirley, I think Ms. Lance ladies. And noch ein gute Sache will ich bezeilen. Es ist du, eine junge Frau, was ist gekommen in der Nacht, Roslyn, ich sehe sie nicht jetzt auf der Screen, aber ihr Mama und meine Mama sind gewesen zusammen in Lager, sind gewesen in Skarzisko, Lager. Und sehr sach Jura noch der Mochumme, meine Tat hat gehabt ein Geschäft auf nicht wart, weil du wusstest nicht gewiss, wie es ist. Und Rosalind's Mom ist gegangen auf dasselbe Gas. Und meine Mutter kann sehen, sie sagt zu mir, Esther, weiß was, ich kenne die Frau. Wehe, ich kicke auf die Frau, sagt sie, das ist toller. Sie ist gewesen mit mir zusammen im Lager. Sie hat geschlafen auf der Pritsch über mir. Anyhow, haben sie reden. Und ich habe gesagt, Mami, das ist die Lady. Ich bin gute Freund mit ihrer Tochter. Ich bin gewesen, schon 8 Jahre alt. Und also hat man sich gefunden. So, Rosalind is here, and she'll say hello when she introduces herself. But her mother and my mother were together in concentration camp, one sleeping above the other. So, we're still very good friends. Our daughters are good friends. So, it's like a continual legacy here. Anyways, that's my story. So,
fantastic.
Fantastic.
I'm going to hand it over to Joe. Joe will do the introductions of some new people and maybe some old people. old people. We're all old people. I mean, people that haven't been here before.
We're not, Ms. Nicht Alt, Ms. Wiesuchman, seasoned. Wiesuchman is Yiddish.
Seasoned veterans.
How do you say pepper?
Pepper.
Pepper. Pepper. A bit of pepper.
Salts and pepper.
So where is Roz? That's your friend. Let's find her.
Right here. I'm right here.
Where is she? Well,
I'm right here.
I see you, Roz. Would you introduce yourself? Zugins a bissel von deine Mishpoche, wie du wohnst jetzt?
Ich wohne jetzt in just north of Toronto.
Oh.
Is where I live. Esther Shear lives near me too.
You don't have to wait.
Okay. Are you Thornhill people?
Yeah. Yes.
Yay! Braunschweig.
Yes. That's right. That's right. And I'm still working. I think I'll work for another 3 years.
We have some background noise. Please mute your phones, please.
I don't have any background noise, so I decided to come on to this, but I also invited two of my cousins from the States. One you met last week, which is Susan, and the other one came tonight, Tina Goldman. So we're all family. Our
Wie hast du gelernt dein Yiddish? Roz, kannst du mich hören?
She froze.
It's Canada.
I have that effect on people. Well, let's go to Tina. Where's Tina?
Here. Ich bin Roslyn's cousin. Roslyn's mama and my mama were in concentration camp and labor camps together. They were first cousins. Ich red nicht Yiddish, as I get. Ich versteh's
a long weekend.
Besser, but I try. Ich wohnt in New York. Ich hab zwei, hold on, let me think about this, Tochters. Ich hab wohnt in Brooklyn, when ich bin a kleiner Kind. And what else? Roz told us about this, and Esther, it's very interesting because I don't know the relationship between your mom and my mom, but they were in the same labor camp.
You were in Skarzyszko?
Sure was, sure
and
was.
And Esther Michaels is here. I saw Esther. Hi, Esther.
Yep.
Her mother's also in Skarzyszko, Kamila.
Yeah. Yeah. They were at the ammunitions factory.
That's right.
That's right.
That's right. Yep.
Making the ammunition. Yeah.
That's right. That's right.
As was mine.
As was yours.
Really, Susan?
As well.
We're all cousins. Wow. Tina, Roz, and myself, all our mothers were first cousins.
Wow. That's amazing that
they were all together.
Survive. That's a miracle.
It is.
I can tell you a story too.
You should, Esther. Esther is here to join us tonight. Where is she?
Is Esther
right here? Right here.
Esther is here. There she is.
Yeah.
I think you've been with us before, Esther.
I've been with you before, but I haven't been a couple weeks already. I also had the same experience. I mean, when we first met, when we started the Daughters of Survivors group, there were 10 girls, and I think half of them, their parents were in Skarzyszko Kamina. There were 3 buildings there, but they all made ammunition. And my mother was taken there from another camp, work camp, slave labor camp. They happened to pull her off the train. They were going to Treblinka, where all her siblings passed away, and her parents and grandparents. But they needed women with smaller hands, so they had to put the powder into the bullets. So that's when my mother and father met, because my father manned one of the machines and my mother was putting bullet powder in. And there was a book written about the people turning yellow, because a lot of people that put the bullets powder in, they turned yellow and they died. My father had a wife and child before the war, and he couldn't get on the same train that went to Treblinka, so that he met my mother in this camp. But anyways, why I'm telling you this is, I was at a shivel in Toronto probably about 15 years ago, and there was a girl there, a tall, stodgy girl. And I said to her, we went for dinner afternoon, and I said, you're born in Toronto? She says, yeah. I says, your parents are Canadian? She says, no, no. She says, my parents are survivors of the Holocaust. So I said, where? And she says, Skarzysko Kamina. I said, my mother was there. So she said, call your mother. I called my mother. My mother just passed away last week, 96 and a half, and she had Alzheimer's. Anyway, so I called her. I spoke to my mother. I said, mother, gedenks at Rosa Milgram. She says, sure, make a schluffen zusammen the Zelba Bank. The Kapishan offense, because they were afraid to go out to the bathroom. They could get raped or they would have been shot to death. So they just, practically everybody just did whatever they had to do on top. So she says, I'd like to meet your mother. But my mother, she said, her mother had Alzheimer's. But we went to Kiva's in this bagel restaurant. And we're sitting there, my mother's sitting across from her, and she says, Ruzha, Ruzha, gedenkstish me, don't remember me, she says. So my girlfriend says, my mother has Alzheimer's. She looked good, but she had Alzheimer's. My mother says, Alzheimer's, Schalpiver, Sisimig, you don't remember me? But she was so excited to see her. So I asked my mother many years later, how come you weren't friends with all these women that I knew some of their kids that was friends with them in school? Why weren't you friends with all these women from Skarzysko that you spent the time in the camps with? And she never answered me, but now I know why, because now that I know the stories, who knows what they happened to these women. So they were never friends with the people they worked with. They were friends with people from their town before the war. They were friends with people that knew survivors, but they weren't friends with the people they were in camp with. It was, women got raped and were beaten, whatever happened in those days, but they didn't want those memories. So they didn't remain friends with a lot of the people that they were in camp with. Naomi, I see Naomi's on here. Naomi, your mother was in Skarzysko too. Naomi's my cousin.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Naomi, have you been with us before?
Yeah, I was with you before. Naomi's a very good joke teller.
And she speaks a better Yiddish, and she's the youngest. She's the youngest here. She speaks the best Yiddish.
Naomi, what's the fight? It's Witz.
Oh, yeah. It's a sach.
Kennst du Zugen auf Witz?
Später.
Okay.
Yiddish.
Is your sister?
Yiddish,
yeah. Hi,
Tova. Hi, Tova. Mike, Esther, is there anyone else here that's new to us?
No, I don't think Brad.
Raise your hand if you're new.
Can you have a zogen? So du zera sachte ater in Yiddish.
I came back. I was here. Haven't shown up for a few weeks, a few times, but I'm back tonight.
Jerry, zugens a bissel von deine Mishpuche.
Meine Mishpuche. Mein Mama und mein Buben Zede haben gekommen von Russland. Und als ein kleines Kind, mein Tat und Mama hat das Geschäft, aber sie haben gearbeitet 15, 16 Uhr Stunde a Tag. So ich hab mein Buben Zede haben gerebt, neben wie mein Tate Mama hat gehabt, sehr Geschäft. So jeden Tag, wenn ich hab gekommen heim vom Schuh, ich hab gegangen zu mein Buben Zede. Der Buben Zede haben gesprochen Russisch in Jiddisch. So ich hab nicht gekannt, hab nicht gelernt Englisch. So sie nur Russisch und Jiddisch. Sie haben gehabt große Tannis zu Russland, wie von der Pogrom. Und so sie haben nicht geredet in Russisch euch, nur Jiddisch. Na so, ich habe geredet Jiddisch.
Sehr schön.
Das war so, ich habe gekannt zu sprechen zu meinem Buben Zede. Nachdem ich habe gegangen in jiddische Schule, nicht Cheder, jiddische Schule. Ich habe gegangen zu einer Schule, was heißt the Morris Winchevsky School. Es war the Communist School in Canada.
And so is that on Lawrence Avenue?
And dort ich habe gelernt mehr Jiddisch. Ich habe gelernt nur reden, euch zu schreiben, zu lesen Yiddish, ich habe gekannt lesen der Yiddische Journal, the Tug, the Forwards. Bis jetzt, ich kann still lesen Yiddish, ein bisschen, nicht so Krieg, nicht so schnell, aber jetzt, ihr könnt reden Yiddish und lesen Yiddish.
Sehr schön, sehr schön. Who else do we have? Wer noch ist du? Oh, there's Anna Schiffer at the hand of her. Anna, you unmute yourself. Wait, Anna, unmute yourself, please. Ah, now you had it. Jetzt kannst du inzoomen ein bisschen von dir.
Ja, ich bin Anna, auf Jiddisch, ich bin ich Hanne. Ich bin neu hier. Ich wohne in New Jersey, in the United States. Ich bin geboren in Rumänien, noch der Milchume. Meine Mama und Tate haben überlebt die Milchume in Taschkent und in Samarkand. Sie sind nicht gewesen in den Camps. Und ich will Hashem Dank geben zu Barbara Wind. Sie hat mich zu dieser Gruppe gebracht.
Wer hat dir gesagt?
Barbara.
Oh, Barbara, okay. Und wie hast du gelernt dein Yiddish?
In der Heim haben meine Eltern Deutsch gesprochen zu mir. Aber wenn sie haben gewollt, ein bisschen mehr saftig zu reden, haben sie geredet in Jiddisch. Und wenn ich ein klein Mädel war, habe ich nicht gewusst, dass das sind zwei Sprachen, zwei Loschonen. Ich habe gemeint, dass Jiddisch ist gewesen, sich zuzukrimmen nach dem Deutsch. I thought that Yiddish was a way to make fun of German. When I was a kid, it took me a while to understand that these were two different languages. They were so similar.
So you spoke both German and Yiddish?
And Romanian.
And Romanian, okay.
Ich bin geboren in Romania. Und in der Schule hat man Romanian geredet und auf der Straße hat man Romanian geredet. Romanisch.
In wie alt bist du gewesen, dass du gekommen zu Amerika?
16 Jahre.
16?
Wir haben gelebt in Eretz Israel. Ich bin gewesen 12 Jahre alt, haben wir gemacht Aliyah nach Eretz Israel. Und 3 Jahre später sind wir gekommen zu Amerika.
In the kids that basically shame. There's shame.
Joe, can I just tell a funny story with regard to what Anna was talking about, the German and Yiddish?
Jared, please.
When I was in high school, there was in our class, there was a whole group of Jewish kids, Jewish boys mostly. And what happened was we all wanted, if you took German, you could finish off your high school diploma in German in grade 12 instead of going to grade 13. So we thought that was a great idea, and all of us spoke Yiddish. It would be a snap to speak German. We had a teacher who happened to be a Jewish teacher that taught French and German in high school. So we came to class. And one day he asks one of my friends something in German, and my friend answered him in Yiddish. So the teacher looks at him and says, he said, Mr. B, in this class, we don't speak Lower Slavovian German, only Hochdeutsch. He knew exactly what he was doing.
Can I say a funny story? My husband went to Switzerland. And he spoke for business, for work. And for 2 weeks, he spoke only Yiddish because he didn't know German and so forth. everybody also thought that he came, they asked him where he learned his German. It's understandable, but it's not like their German. 2 weeks, everybody thought he spoke German. It's true.
Shirley?
Hannah? Hannah?
She got to unmute herself.
Hannah, unmute. Hannah, do you remember the story with the three of us, Ruth, you and I, at our, in our freshman German class?
I didn't take German, I took French.
That was a different Hannah.
We dropped French and we took German.
You and Ruth took German. I never took German.
My friend Ruth, our professor was very German, very scary. And he would call on you before you'd even realize anything. So he calls on our friend Ruth. How do you say drunk in German? And she freezes like a deer in the headlights. And she said, verschnucket?
And he said, Shirley, you got it wrong.
Wait a minute. So Fräulein Cincinnatus. Das ist betrunken, betrunken, nicht verschnucket.
She didn't say verschnucket. She didn't say verschnucket.
What did she say? You weren't in the class.
She said a schicker. She said a schicker.
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 Could be, but we learned the word for the day was betrunken. Yes.
A betrunkener.
Mike, I have a friend that joined tonight. I wouldn't mind if she'd like to say a little something about herself.
Go ahead.
Barbara, Bar Diane. Where is she? There she is. Oh, you're on mute. You're on mute, Barbara.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Ich bin Agitta Freien, Sester Schier. Wir haben gearbeitet zusammen für 29 Jahre in der Kashrut Council of Canada. Ich arbeite dort noch. Älteren, I speak Hebrew, älteren, mein älteren gewesen in der Milchoma, Tata gewesen in Lodz, Polen, die Mama in kleine Städtel, Wojzenta. Nach dem Alchoma, sie kamen zu Toronto und ich habe zwei Schwestern, ich habe drei Kinder und ich habe eine Klech und ich bin happy zu lernen Yiddish und zu hören die Alemanses.
Wie hast du gelernt dein Yiddish?
Was?
Wie hast du gelernt dein Yiddish?
Mein Eltern, ich bin gelitten Yiddish in der Hohes. Wir geantwortet in Englisch.
Hi, Barbara.
It's Roz. Oh, hi, Roz. How are you?
Okay.
Ich bin freund mit Roz auch. Wir bekennen sich, wenn wir gewesen 8 oder 10 Jahre alt.
8 Jahre alt. Wir freuen uns, dass 8 Jahre
alt.
Kann ich sagen, es ist du sehr sag Yiddish Theater auf Television, nicht Television, auf ihr könnt kriegen E-Mail. Es heißt, es ist ein Theater in der jüdische, was ist es?
Yiddish
Theater in New York. Es ist frei. Und es ist so schön, es ist gewesen wegen der wilden Ghetto, habe ich gesehen, Nächten. A schöne Halb, geschrieben bei der Freu, es ist gewesen sehr gut Theater. Und ich, auf jüdische, die Biene, der Theater bin ich. Ihr könnt es gefunden on
YouTube.
On your,
yeah. Es ist von die Volksbiene.
Volksbiene. Did you see it?
Ich denke, sie hat das Wilma Ghetto. I think it was the Warsaw Ghetto, no?
No, that's something else. Yeah, the Warsaw Ghetto, they had it today also. They had
Die Feugel von die Ghetto or something.
So,
like
but
that.
The Vilna Ghetto is a spiel. Okay. The Warsaw Ghetto is music. Sie singen etwas. a neue Lied von der Warsaw Ghetto, was auf Englisch geschrieben. Aber die Wilde Ghetto ist so gut, ich habe schon lange nicht gesehen, dass es ein jüdisches Theater gibt. Ein frei, aber noch zwei, drei Tage. Ich muss es machen schnell. Heute kannst du sehen, dass es viele.
Do you people remember the young man that joined us? I think it was, he was only with us one night, but he was an actor from New York in the Yiddish theater.
Yeah.
I wonder if he went back. Do we have any contact information on him?
It was wonderful. He made the music, remember?
Here in Charleston. But he was doing some kind of class here, so he couldn't join us. I also asked him to sing, and he said, I can't do that either because I'm in the union, and they don't allow me to sing for free.
Right. I just wondered if he went back to New York and is in the theater again.
I'll contact. I've got his email. And
his Yiddish was magnificent.
Yeah. Yeah.
So
I think Roz wanted to fix him up with her niece or something.
Joe, I want to ask Esther to get us going on a few jokes and sayings and things like that that she was going to.
Naomi.
And
I have a joke.
And
the moisture that is English, because no Spanish. Just that it's Hebrew, there's no Spanish. That it's Russian, no Spanish. Just Busep is Spanish. Just when that it's Samir, Spanish.
I think okay. Anne wanted to talk. I think Anne wanted to talk.
Interpret. We need to interpret that joke, Naomi. English.
Yeah.
Can Anne say a few words?
Speak English?
One at a time. Hold on.
Spanish. Spanish is don't spit.
Spanish.
Spanish.
Spit. So he says English, he goes, no, Spanish, don't spit. And he thought they're saying Spanish. Okay.
Okay.
And you wanted to say something, Anne?
Not the right crowd.
My mom had also gone to Tashkent in the Monchoma. You are the only one who has heard that their Eltern have given dort an Ochet.
Who went to Tashkent?
My mom is given in Tashkent and Anna's Elfen is an Ochet given in Tashkent.
Oh. My parents were in Tashkent. Although they were not married to each other back then. They didn't know each other.
No?
No, they only met after the war. They met in Bucharest in 1947.
Weißt du, was I have with him, Doctor? Was war in Tashkent?
Kinder?
No, deine Eltern. Was haben sie getan in Tashkent?
Ich weiß nur, was mein Mann hat getan. Sie hat gearbeitet in einem Spital. She was a hospital orderly. Und nachdem hat sie gearbeitet in einem Heim, wo sie hat geholfen mit einem Kind. Es ist gewesen eine Familie, die Mama ist gewesen sehr krank und meine Mama hat geholfen mit dem Baby. Es ist so gewesen ein kleines Kind, like a toddler, a baby or a toddler. Und meine Mama hat dort geholfen und dort hat sie gehabt, ein bisschen mehr zu essen. Sie hat gewusst von Hitler, sie hat nicht gewusst von Camps, sie hat gar nicht gewissen von Camp.
Mama
hat nicht gewissen von Auschwitz, sie hat nicht gewissen von gar nicht.
Meine Mama hat gesagt, dass die Menschen dort seine Gewinner so fein und so gibt sie ihr. Sie hat das gesagt, ich kenne nicht. Sot herausgegangen, derselbe Weg sot herangekommen.
Wow.
You know, wow. She was treated so well. She went in, she was just turning 16. Sorry, now I'm speaking in English. Now I can't say it even in Yiddish. She was 16. Her mother was sent to Tashkent, and my mother said, she was the oldest of five, but don't know, you stay with the kids. I'm gonna go, I'll go in your place. And she went, and because she was young, you know, she was at that age, my mother said, because they looked at her, and my mother said, because she had a cute rear end, they gave her an easy job. And they said to her, do you know how to ride a horse? And my mother said she'd never been near a horse, but she said to them, of course I can ride a horse. My parents knew enough that during the war, whatever they asked you, you said yes, because no meant you got killed. So my mother's job was she would ride this horse from farm to farm that they were working. And her job was like an accountant to take down the numbers of how much they were picking or growing at the time. And she said she was so proud of the fact that she wasn't raped, she wasn't treated poorly, which was so different from the rest of my aunt's experiences. So I just was curious about what your parents' experience was.
Wow. Yeah, my parents didn't talk about this for many years. By the time that generation started to talk about it, my father was no longer with us. So my mother didn't start talking until the 90s. Now I had heard some of the stories because when I was little, they thought I was asleep, and then they would start to talk, and I wasn't asleep, and I was picking up some stuff, but not enough to really put together the whole history. But my mother was 18 when she ended up in Tashkent and Samarkand, and I don't remember which came first. If Samarkand came first or Tashkent, I don't remember that. I have to go through her video.
Anna, can
she recorded a video with the Fortune of Archives.
Mike, you had something for us?
What I wanted to do is we've got a lot of people that are making connections. We're going to keep the line open after 9 o'clock so folks can connect and tell stories and make connections offline. But I know Esther has a program plan for us. She wants to share a lot, and we want to get into telling jokes and stories and having a little bit of fun. So if you want to stay on, I know we have some potential connections that we want to make. Stay on after 9. And Esther, why don't you take over and see if you can get us going in terms of
the Darf Lachen, okay, Esther, the Darf Lachen.
The Darf Lachen, Bissala, Biskrach, Joe, Biskrach. So I don't know if I should say the bit. I'll just say a little introduction about it. For those of you who don't know me, because everyone who does know me knows I love proverbial sayings. And the Yiddish Sprachwort, once you translate it, it loses something in the translation. But I have a collection of about 45, 50 pages that I've collected through the years of all the different Sprachworts, different sayings. And last week, Al, he's not here, 2 weeks ago, Al brought up, I don't know whoever was here, he was talking about curses. And they were talking about cholera and choleria and all this. So I decided to follow up. So this is for Al, really, but he's not here tonight. So I just thought I'd mention a couple of curses now in Yiddish. And let's see if anybody can understand it or if it's funny to anyone. So this is a curse. Alle zehn sollen bei ihm herausfallen, nur einer soll im Blaben auf a Zumweitig. Okay, so what does that mean? For those of you who don't know, it means all his teeth should fall out except one to make him suffer with a toothache. So this was the type of humor, it was a very dry humor that these curses, I don't even know if they would call them a curse. Is it really a curse? It was more of a, okay, anyways, let's call it a curse. Doesn't matter. Okay, let's see if you know this one. Is all vaxen via zibala mit dem Kopf in Dreert.
Yeah.
And the feet are off.
The feet are, yeah.
Okay, that I don't know. He should grow. So in English it translated, it's he should grow like an onion with his head in the ground. Okay. Now, this one I actually thought was funny because I thought this is a good one.
Ich wünsche mir, es soll haben ein größeres Geschäft, es soll haben eine Sachsreude. Was ist, wenn der Mensch kommt und fragt ihn, hat er nicht haben das Reude, und wenn er will es kaufen, ist es nicht du. So, what is the curse? The curse is, I wish on you a very large store, and whatever people ask for, he shouldn't have, and what he does have shouldn't be requested. So in other words, he's not wishing him too well to, he's not, you know, I thought that was a good one, actually. So those are the types of, so, right?
Very good.
Yeah, that's just a couple. I'm not going to go into too many of them tonight because I'm saving them as we go along.
Maybe somebody, a favorite one, but it's not a curse. I don't like to curse in Yiddish, but can I? As me hot es nicht in Kop, hot min is in the feast. It means if you don't have it in your head, if you're not smart to work on an issue, you have to then physically take care of it by using your feet rather than using your head. Okay. I used to do it to my children, whenever they didn't think out of a problem, like they forgot something in school, they had to walk back for it. So I'd say at the hostel is top.
Okay, Shirley's next, and then Sharon.
I just want to reiterate what Tova said. I worked in an inner city school for a few years. And I became friends with a very lovely teacher. And her motto to the students was, if you don't do the thinking, you'll right. do the walking.
It's very good. Thing. I like that.
I wonder if she was Jewish, but she was African.
It's Yiddish, but very good.
Sharon.
Okay.
Esther, did you ever hear this expression?
Jerry.
A what?
Esther, did you ever hear this expression? It's not a cursing expression. My late wife used to say, Nemdish the key of Boydum.
Yeah. I'll just say it.
What is that, Jerry?
Don't get ahead of yourself.
Yeah, that's true. That's a good one.
Remember the ground rule, raise your hand. We're talking on top of people. So Sharon's next.
Okay. My mama gesagt, and ich sagt to meine kleine Kinder and meine große Kinder alle Tag, ein Tuches kann ich tanzen und zwei Chassanes.
Yeah.
It's very good.
What does that mean?
This is good. Yeah.
One Tuches can't dance at two weddings.
Oh, yeah, my mom.
And it's good for anything. Anytime you have a conflict, it's like I can't do it. I can't do both.
That's good, Reggie.
Reggie, you had your hand up.
Ma mitte gesucht ist jede Mal, und ich habe gewillt tanzen auf jede Chassene, und ich habe jede Mal gemacht so viele Sachen, ich kann nicht tun alles dasselbe Mal.
Yeah.
Oh, I have another one that I love. Alles in einem ist die Stube bei keinem. Everything I don't know how to do it in English. It just doesn't work like that. All the good, everything good, you can't find in one person only. Okay. Like if you want to get married, and this is not so great. So you say, alles in einem ist der Stuhl bei keinem. All the good things you can't find in one person.
Okay, Naomi, you have your hand up.
I love that.
My mother had a good one. And the translation, I'll tell you first, is, oh, that's how you do it. But she used to say, oh, a zoikoft mit luxion. And the translation to that is, oh, that's how you cook the noodles. Yeah. But the translation is really like, oh, that's how you do it.
That's cute.
Jerry's got his hand up. Go ahead, Jerry.
Sharon, I think my late wife had a similar expression. But they took us Kenmanish for night zwei Pferd. With one took us, you can't ride on two horses. Yeah. It's a very takeoff on the same thing.
Yeah.
So I have a question for Anne Eisenberg. Did your mother ever go horseback riding after she was freed?
No. Any animals, if she could at all help it. My mother did not go camping. My mother did not go near farms. Nothing. Nothing.
Okay. Barbara.
But I have to tell you, she had a cute little figure. She was right.
Barbara's got her hand up. Go ahead, Barbara. You're mute. We don't hear you.
We can't hear you, Barb.
I think Barbara, I think your microphone's not working.
You're on mute, Barbara.
Barbara, you're still on mute.
No, not yet. Try again.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
So my mother was also in various parts of Russia and wound up in Georgia in the Caucasus during the war. And she was on a kolkhoz, a communal farm, and she had to ride a horse. And when I wanted to go horseback riding, she said, "Are you crazy?" She never saw the glamour in that because she, you know, it was a workhorse. It was not a pleasure for her.
Interesting.
So I want to pivot for a second, and Ron Arsham wanted to share an opportunity that he's been working on, and he asked to give us a few minutes to share about. I don't know how do you say bingo in Yiddish? I don't know. How's
bingo? You don't know bingo. I think it's called bingo.
It's all bingo. So he wants to talk about bingo.
What does bingo mean? I don't know if there's an actual definition, but thank you. Thank you, Mike and Fred and Joe and everybody who invited me. I tried to get on last few weeks, but I guess I couldn't make it because the link wasn't working for me. So anyway, I'm Ron Arsham. This is my wife, Marilyn, and Mike. I see you're from Charleston. This is Marilyn's from Charleston.
Oh, Dave really? Popowski.
Is that Dave?
Are you from Charleston, Dave?
Popowski. David here, David Popowski's on in the middle.
I know, I saw it.
Marilyn Schaefer.
David, is that your family with David?
Are you awake, David?
David.
Unmute. Tell me if you're
awake. I'm unmute, David.
Mike, do you know the Schaefer family in Charleston?
Jack Schaefer?
Yeah, I know the name.
What's
okay.
The
name? Anita, do you know Jack Schaefer?
I do.
This is
I know Jack Schaefer too. I'm David's partner. And of course I know Jack, and we went to their son's wedding to our friend's daughter.
We were there. Of course. My godson.
Anita, are you from Toronto? Are you from Toronto?
No, I'm not. I'm from Jacksonville, Florida originally.
Nice sparkle.
All right.
I'm in Jacksonville, Florida.
I didn't want to use
in Toronto.
Anyway, we live in
Maine. Can I say something? Do we raise hands here or what?
Marilyn, are you Jack's sister?
Yes. I'm the oldest.
I'm Rosalind Lancer.
Oh,
and that's Marilyn. My mother, Betty.
Yes.
Hi, Marilyn.
How are you?
See, this is love why we join this thing. Jewish geography works.
I just saw David, and I went, David Popowski. Could there be another David Popowski anywhere?
Marilyn's grandfather reprimanded her brother and I many a time to get back in shul and daven.
Right.
Sam Schaefer.
Anyway, we live in the Jewish bastion of Mayapack, New York, which is the first town outside of Westchester County in Putnam County. We're north and west of the city. We have a small shul, Temple Beth Shalom in Mayapack, which is about 120 members. And Marilyn was a Hebrew school teacher. I'm from Cleveland originally, so all you Clevelanders out there, hi there. Oh, you're Clevelanders?
Cleveland
right.
And Charleston.
Ours are from Cleveland.
Here we go.
Right.
Yeah.
Raise your hand.
Okay.
Marilyn, where do you live now?
We live in Mayapack, New York.
Right, in New York.
It's northern tip of Westchester County, about 45 miles.
You know how close I was with your mom and dad?
with Nat and Lee.
Yeah.
I miss them so much.
Yeah. Anyway, so
did she hurt you?
Marilyn ended up being, you know, was a Hebrew school teacher, and our friends who created this game, this Jewish bingo game with us, are educators. And Linda taught reading disabled kids. You know, they have a tutoring. I'm going back a little bit so you understand where we're coming from in this.
So we would created Hebrew cards because I was teaching and I said, this is going to be fun. So Behrman House actually is selling the Hebrew cards now.
She jumped 50 yards ahead of me. I'm saying because Linda used to work with dyslexics, still does. And she used to use flashcards to link to the kids and they were getting bored. So, you know, she tried to come up with something else. So she developed cards, actual games like Go Fish and all these other things that you could play while you were learning, learning the letters and eating English. So Marilyn asked her if she could do that for Hebrew because she was having a real tough time teaching Hebrew to the kids, you know, after school, you know, at a conservative synagogue. So
we're doing this Yiddish. This is very interesting.
I'm here because it got to be popular and we brought this in show. Behrman House actually bought our Hebrew part of it.
The Hebrew
learning part.
But so this is Yiddish. Yiddish is different.
We're trying to, so that we also developed, they also came up with these cards for Yiddish. And we were going to market them, we were trying to market them the same way, but then COVID hit. So we tried to figure out a way of using these Yiddish cards, which I can, I don't know if you can see all these, but you can see here.
Where is the Yiddish cards?
There it is. He's showing it.
But it's not in Yiddish. I mean,
but it's not in it's a translation.
This is a game. This is a fun game that we've been marketing to mostly sisterhoods. And I didn't think about men's clubs, but men's clubs too, for both fun, for just a fun evening, and also it could be a fundraiser. Okay.
So for example, I mean, you get the bingo card. And it can be up to 90 something people can be playing at the same time. And each one will have a unique card, you know, a neat sheet of it. And on the card, it has the word, like farblungen. Then it has the meaning. And then it has an example.
Oh, that's nice.
We got so far blunged, we missed the Shiva call. We ended up at a wedding reception. Everyone thought we were from the other side. So we stayed the best chopped liver ever. And each one has something, you know, cute, like a little part of the saying, like Bissell, a little bit. I'll have a Bissell of cake. Why should I deny myself? But so little? Is that all you can spare?
Ron, why don't you stay on after 9? We'll talk a little bit more, but you'll send me the information and I'll send it out to the group because we have about 400 people on our distribution.
Yeah, it's fun.
And the question is, can we do this on a Zoom? Can we?
Originally it wasn't, but we developed it so we can play it. We play it at home now. We do it on Saturday nights or whatever. And we've had as many as 35 people for us.
Maybe one time we'll try to do it with this group.
Yes, that'd be fun.
But there's a website, which I'll put on, the chat. And
why don't you share that all with me? I'll make sure that everybody gets
okay.
it.
Okay.
So
thank you.
So we're getting down to the end, and we picked out a couple of interesting songs. And so why don't we play one, and then we'll stay on after 9 to chat. So let me see if I can find this. Hold on a second.
I have to figure it out.
Damon's Katz is the Susan. That's the Katz.
What was it?
Oh. Wo ist
das Städtele? Was ist der Name von deinem Katz?
Wo ist das Städtele?
Woody.
Wo ist das Städtele?
Wo sagst du?
Städtele is cat? No.
No. Katz.
A Katz.
A Katz is a Katz.
This is a hint.
Okay. I thought you asked the name of the cat.
Woody.
Hold on a second.
I have
the question is, would she?
This, here we go.
That's not it.
What was the question?
It's not would he. The question is, would she?
Oh, would she? Okay. This is, okay.
All right, let me see if I can get this on. This was really a nice one that was shared. One second.
I have two more cats. The other ones are Buzz and Jesse.
All right, we'll talk more about them next time.
Hold on, let's see if we got this.
That's like one of my favorites.
Isn't that beautiful? Yeah.
They're good. They're good. Weren't they on the voice, like, and they were singing bum, bum, chitty bum, 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 and the voice turned around because they heard them singing Yiddish and they didn't know what they were singing? You see that?
Oh, we have that one.
Yeah, we have
it. We have that. We'll show that maybe next time. That's right, that there is a voice.
Mm-hmm.
No, the voice was from
Ukraine.
And they were singing Yiddish. We could show that one. It would be great. So we had one quick question. So we got people have talked about, we try to do a two groups, you know, less English, less Yiddish. So I want to try to do a little poll here and see what you guys think. No, watch this. This is a poll. I'm going to try a poll here. So I'm going to ask this question. It's should we do more Yiddish, more English, or is the balance about right? So you all ought to see this poll, and we'd be interested in hearing so we could really design these sessions so that everybody would be happy.
You can't make a bunch of Jews happy. Come on.
All right. Well,
or agree.
I think that what are they called in that the tribe has spoken.
Oh yeah, the tribe has spoken.
The tribe has spoken. It looks like this group likes the balance the way it is, with a few more people wanting more Yiddish, but it sounds like it's about right. But we're going to send out a poll like this to the 375 people. Al Davis asked if people wanted to learn Yiddish. He's taught Yiddish, and we'll see if folks want to learn Yiddish, and we'll ask that. It'd be a different group. So anyway, I'm going to, go ahead, Esther. Esther, you're on mute.
Yeah, I just wanted to understand, first of all. See, when you have group that's mixed like this, I have a feeling there's so many things that are going on. There are people whose parents weren't survivors of the Holocaust, but their grandparents spoke Yiddish, so they want to keep that in their vocabulary, and they want to keep that Yiddish tight. That's the name of your group. But then there's the ones whose children came from survivors of the Holocaust, which is a whole different thing. And I think that's what causes so many people to get excited and start talking, because as children of survivors, we never talked about things with our parents. With very few stories that were told until after Schindler's List was made, then they start to talk a little bit, and that wasn't until the 90s. So then we get excited when we start to see somebody that's from the same town. I don't know if that's of interest when we start talking about our parents' experience to the ones who are here that parents weren't survivors, because it's so different, it's so diverse. So, you know, you want to make everybody happy, and like you said, it's hard to make all the Jewish people happy. So you gotta, you know, because when we do talk Yiddish, I'm not great at talking Yiddish, some are better than others. But when you talk the Yiddish, it's hard to translate in English because it loses its old tom. You know what that means, the tom, you know. Yeah. But also you have to find out if everybody here who's really not a child as a survivor, because it's a whole different ballgame. You have to understand if they don't mind us telling the story as we get excited, you know, because we never talked about it. That's why my group is so successful, because now we're talking about it amongst ourselves. And a lot of us knew each other because we were from the same neighborhoods. But we only knew each other because our parents there were their friends, because they had no family, so they became their friends and their children. So you have to ask them if they're interested in hearing the stories, because we get excited to tell the story.
Well, Ruth, Esther's going to help design that. Ruth and then Anita.
Am I muted? Oh, okay. I just wanted to say, in terms of learning Yiddish, I don't know how many of you are familiar with the computer app Duolingo. Duolingo just came out. I already finished the Hebrew course. Duolingo just came out with the Yiddish course. I'm enrolled in it. You learn Yiddish on your own pace. It's a lot of fun. They teach you it by like with goofy sentences, like your bathroom has no lights. You have to know how to say that in Yiddish. Your bathroom has no lights. Dein Badezimmer hat nicht Licht. And when you do goofy sentences, it's a way to remember it, but it's a lot of fun. It's free. And it's Duolingo, Duolingo. They teach about 40 different languages, but Yiddish is the newest one. And Ruth, sign up.
I'm gonna send out a link to that on the next follow-up at the end of the week. Anita, you had your hand up. You have to turn your mute off, go ahead.
Ich hab geschickt a message to Esther Shear and to Esther M. Ich bin a Tochter of survivors. Mein Mama and mein Tata.
Yeah, we all.
Yeah. And ich will reden mehr Yiddish.
Yiddish.
But yeah, ich hab lieb zu reden Yiddish in the heim.
Sharon, go ahead.
I've also been getting into the Duolingo, but please know that this is not your everyday Yiddish. This is, I think, the Lubavitch or the very religious. It's a different sound, and
it's not Yivo Yiddish. I think they're aiming at Hasidic Brooklyn Yiddish. So. That's a little frustrating. But in this group, I've heard it too. Like, not people are not saying vu is die Gesele, they are saying V is die Gesele. So right here in this group, I'm hearing the same thing. So it's not that weird.
Barbara Wind?
Barbara?
Yes.
Barbara, go ahead.
Is that .com? Or how do you get to Duolingo?
D-U-O. Duolingo.
But where do you get it? Do you go .com or how do you get it?
I think if you hit .com, it'll pull it up and then you can sign up and it's free.
Okay, thank you.
Barbara Wind.
I want to say
go ahead, Barbara.
You know, as Rachel Schechter from the Forwards learned an Yiddish Wort jeden Tag. And you can just say on YouTube or Gmail or your Gmail. Sie ist sehr gut.
If you do that, if you sign up for the forward, it comes in their email that they send you.
Yeah.
There's a piece of it. So if you sign up to get the forward,
But you can also get it on YouTube.
You can also get it on Facebook.
Facebook.
Wow. On various Facebook groups, she's a member of different Facebook groups, and she posts every day the word of the day.
The word of the day, yeah.
The Yiddish word of the day.
Thank you. I gotta go. Thank you so much for a great evening.
Me too.
David, thanks for being with us.
So we had two connections tonight. There were a bunch of Tashkents. Because our very close friend in Cleveland, Cincinnati, I should say, was from Tashkent. He was born there.
David, you have your hand up.
Yeah, I just want back to Marilyn. I just wanted to mention that her father, who was a dear friend of mine as well, he was a liberator. He was the liberated Ordruff.
Wow.
One part of the U.S. Army team that liberated Ordruff.
He was very
perplexed about it. I talked to him, Marilyn, several times about it.
He's very choked up about it.
Barry, go ahead. You have to unmute yourself.
Barry Wagner.
There you go.
Hi. Whatever happened to the idea of having breakout rooms for those who are more fluent in Yiddish and those who are less fluent in Yiddish?
Well, that was one of the reasons we asked the poll tonight, because we haven't figured out yet, and we still have to figure out how to design one for less fluent, because most people want to be in the bigger group. So Barry, let's maybe offline get some ideas on how we might want to do that, because right now most of the people here wanted to do about the same as we're doing or more Yiddish. So you know, it's a challenge to make everybody happy. But Barry, I'd love to talk to you offline to see how we might be able to do it, and maybe we can bring more people in that want that balance.
Please, I'd be glad to help in any way.
Thanks, Barry.
Thank you.
Hannah.
Michael, honey, Esther said she lost power, so she didn't leave intentionally. She lost power.
Okay.
Esther Shear.
Okay.
That happened to us once. We got hit by lightning, remember?
Hannah?
Go ahead, Hannah.
Ich tracht also wie Anita, dasselbe. Ich bin auch die Tochter von Holocaust Survivors und ich will mehr Yiddish. Und ich habe gewollt eine Gruppe, wo es mehr Yiddish.
Fred, you wanted to say something.
Go ahead, Fred. You have to take your mute off. Unmute.
Fred, we can't hear you.
Can't hear you.
Can't hear. Try again.
Fred?
Say something. Your speaker's not working.
You've got a microphone problem.
Shirley, translate to Mike.
What?
Translate to Mike what I said.
What did she say?
Oh, I will.
Okay.
I'm sorry, we can't hear you.
Anyone else have a comment?
Okay, yes,
Cheryl, you're shaking your head. What is your comment? Cheryl.
Anna,
yeah, we're talking to you.
Yeah, I was telling Fred, no, we can't hear you, because it looked like he was saying, can you hear me?
Yeah, we can't hear him. I've got to find out where Ron was from in Cleveland, because we got
Jaker.
Jaker.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Shirley graduated from Heights, and I graduated from Brush.
My brother was a graduate.
I graduated from Heights High.
Yeah, my brother went to Woodbury Junior High.
Ah.
But then we moved to Shaker. I went to Belvoir School when I was
Yeah.
So I was in University Heights.
That's where
we're gesund alle mit der Sehen in zwei Wochen.
Yeah.
But I have plenty of cousins and everybody around Cleveland.
We'll have to find out who
last
they
name
are.
Is very popular.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Both good and bad.
Edie,
go ahead.
Edie.
Yeah. Is there anybody on who is still on from Toronto?
Yeah, we have.
Yes, I'm from Toronto.
Esther Michelson's on, and
okay.
Because
my granddaughter just won an award, and she's going to be in Toronto doing a master's, and she's the water polo goalie for the University of Toronto.
Wow, yeah. Great. Mazel tov. Mazel tov. Naches.
Edie, we probably can have some people make soup for her on Friday or something like that. How old is she?
She is 21.
Oh, my oldest is 19 and a half. So
that's okay. It's all
yeah.
right.
Yeah.
Right, thank you. We're gonna go, but I'll send you the link for the website, and I'll contact you, and you can pass along all the information. But it was
and
a lot
before,
of fun.
Before you guys go, I just want to say that I'm a neighbor. I'm on the Croton border in Westchester as well.
Oh.
So you're all right. Ooh. You look familiar. Were you on one of our calls before?
Thank you. This is wonderful. I'm seeing people from Charleston.
We got our shots at the Save More Drug and on 129.
Yeah.
That's right.
I'm gonna go.
Be well, everyone.
Okay, take care.
All right. It was good to see everyone. We'll see you in 2 weeks. We have a lot more songs. Oh, go ahead, Esther.
Wiedersehen.
Yeah.
Esther Scheer, you were
No, she's just saying.
No, you're on mute, Esther.
You're on mute.
Yeah.
Esther, thank you so much for helping us, and we'll be in touch. And everybody, thank you. Have a great week.
Too. Thank you.
Thank you.
We'll play bingo one night, all of us together on Zoom. How's that?
Shirley, I'm going to look for those pictures.
Yes, please.
And we've
do.
Got more pictures than what I sent you. There's a lot more. So if you could identify a few of the people that in the picture
I'm looking to see if I can recognize my father-in-law, but your parents look like they're in these pictures that I saw. That's why I want to show them to you.
Oh, that would be something else. Yeah, we've been going through a lot of pictures, and actually I got an app to colorize, and there's another app that actually enhances these pictures. So some of these pictures are just unbelievable. Yeah, I can pull them up. Yeah.
Did you want to ask Mike about Leia Hockman?
Yes, I mentioned it to Mike. Esther could send you the link to this woman that I told you, who's 100.5 years old, who speaks beautifully. She's articulate in Yiddish and English, of course, to tell her story. I don't know if you're interested.
Her story is different because she walked through Poland for 2 years, pretended she was a Polish woman, but she's very spiritual. She's quite amazing for her age. And she remembers detail better than me and Esther together. I swear she was amazing. I'll send you when she did our talk with us, but she was on for over an hour, and then there was another survivor on, so I introduced them, and they started talking for another hour. They were on almost 2.5 hours, and she was not tired, this woman.
Wow.
It's amazing, amazing. And she lives on her own,
Wow. Yeah. Esther, see if you have that picture.
You have these picture?
No, I don't have that picture.
Okay. That's me.
Is that you? Is that you, Shirley?
Yes, and my parents.
Wow, they were so beautiful. Your mother and father, very handsome and very beautiful woman.
Thank you.
So nice. You know what? I'm going to look through. I just haven't been able to find the package. I put it somewhere a couple of weeks ago. I was working on some pictures, but I want to show them to you.
Yeah. Where are your parents from, Shirley? Shirley, where are your parents from?
Her parents were, after the war, ended up in Italy, Esther, and my in-laws did too. And they were in near Milan.
This is Shirley's parents at their wedding. The color I added, that's more recent, but.
And Eisenberg also in Italy. In a small town, they came to, she said the name of the town, Trieste.
Oh,
Trieste.
Not far.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
But Shirley's parents and my in-laws were actually near Milan, the same, and they both went to Cyprus.
They probably knew each other. I'm sure they probably
knew each other.
That's amazing.
Here's a few.
Yeah. Those are see the one on the top left? That's the type I have. The top left with all the men. I have those kind of pictures. Many of them.
That's where? In Italy? That's in Italy?
In Italy. Like the top one with all the, with the bikes.
Yeah, you see that?
Yeah.
You should show these to Anne Eisenberg because she's made her own bigger.
Yeah, you're right.
Where is?
I went out. Would you believe I went to the dollar store and bought a magnifying glass because I want to look closely at the pictures to see.
But if you
it's
take a
same.
Picture, Esther, if you take the picture of the picture with your phone, then you can pull it open on your phone.
Oh, good idea. Yeah.
Yeah, you
that's
don't need
what
a magnifying glass. It's even better.
Any of these pictures look familiar?
That one doesn't, no.
That's my.
The ones that I saw were near the beach, like they were in a lake or wherever they were, and on bikes and that kind of thing.
Yeah. We'll have to send you some pictures and see if you know who's who.
Yeah.
It would be nice to show, I don't know if they're interested, that's the thing. If you have pictures of old, like I have pictures or Esther's pictures, to tell the story of their parents when they were young and how they met and
of course that's
what their
very
families
nice
look like. I don't know if anybody's interested in that thing.
That's very nice. We should think about that. It's a nice activity. Anyways, it's been a pleasure. You had a successful
It will be fun to figure out where the connection is, you know. I mean, this is good. Yeah. They could have been best friends, you know, for all we
you
know.
Never know.
Found family. You never know.
Oh, really?
I know. I told her she's a Lunce lady. I have a feeling I have a Lunce lady in South Carolina. Is that where you are? South Carolina?
South Carolina.
Anytime.
So how did your family go to South Carolina?
We have a big empty house too. And we're
How did you end up in South Carolina?
Reggie.
Our friend.
Did you see Reggie? Reggie, we knew for like 30 years, 40 years, and she moved down here and we used to visit her. And we came down for a spring break. And we said, let's look for a place maybe. And so we looked and looked and looked, and that Friday we signed a contract to build a house.
But how did your parents come from? When your parents came from Europe, where did they got papers to the United States, or they had a relative after the war?
My parents, my aunt and uncle and my parents met in the camp. My aunt had a lot of family in Cleveland, Ohio. So they were able to come. My parents had no one to sponsor them, but my mother just wanted to go to Israel. Well, it was Palestine. So we went and the British caught our ship. And that's another similarity. We were incarcerated on Cyprus till Israel.
That's where they were. Yeah.
So
they were in Cyprus. And then my husband was born on April 17th, 1948. It was the day that Israel became a state.
My
father fought for that.
In 47, March of 47.
What, you were born?
Yeah, I'm a year older than your husband.
Yes, that's
you're
right.
The same age as my husband. He's turning 74 on Thursday.
Okay.
So you're awesome. A month after you.
We both turned 74 this year.
And Joe turned 74, a week ago?
A week ago. Right.
Edie,
so how long were you?
Edie, you were born in Israel, right? In Palestine, right?
I was born in Palestine. And my father fought in the army for Israel and came home and he said, yay, we have a Medina Shelanu, Achshav, Usamach.
Yeah. And Edie lives in Charleston.
But Edie's pretty famous. Edie's from Canada. And I can't bend around because she was-
We're Montreal? Were you from Montreal, Edie?
Montreal, yes. My husband is from Montreal and we met on the swim team.
So she was an international swimmer. She qualified for the Olympics for Canada.
Wow. That's amazing. That's very nice. My son played in the Maccabee about 3 years ago.
We had two granddaughters at the Maccabee in three years ago.
So they were there together. My son is much older. My son is 48.
One represented South Africa and one represented the United States.
And my son represented Canada baseball.
I posted a picture today on Facebook of what's going on in Tel Aviv. The whole country opened up.
Yeah.
People are on the beach, thousands of people enjoying themselves. The COVID is gone. I think COVID's gone there.
I spoke to my girlfriend today in Israel for 2 hours and she told me, she said, "Akol beseder, akol patuach."
Zelonachon. Israel just ordered 1 million more vaccines.
Yes.
The young people and the Haredim or the very Orthodox don't want to be vaccinated.
Right.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
Yeah. Our friends who have children in school, she said it got very bad again because people think COVID is over. It's not.
So I posted that. I thought it's over. I thought it was over in Israel.
It's better than
that year.
I'm in Toronto and we have it very bad right now. Very bad.
There's in Montreal.
We don't have enough vaccines and we're continually, they're opening clinics, closing clinics. It's such a surge. We're in a really bad third wave.
Have you been vaccinated?
We're in lockdown. We're in lockdown till May 20th. We're not even allowed to, it's just unbelievable what's going on here.
Do you have an 8 o'clock curfew?
No curfew.
Because they have curfew in Montreal, 8 o'clock.
I know. We're not at that point yet. Who knows?
I was in Florida for 10 weeks, got my vaccines in January, then came home, had two tests before I came home, crossed the border, had to go to Montreal, had to stay home for 2 weeks. The Gestapo came once to the house. Then they called us within those 2 weeks about almost 4 or 5 times. Then they send you an email every day. My mother, I passed away. I didn't get to see her. It bothers me so much because I didn't get to see her till she was gone. She wasn't sick. She had Alzheimer's, so we weren't expecting her to go. But still, if I didn't have to stay in for 2 weeks, then I am okay with the shot. But they still make us stay home because when we cross the border, the customs guy, the immigration guy says to her, "I don't want to read this, but I have to. If you leave your house for 2 weeks, at all, you have a maximum fine of $1 million or 3 years in jail," he says to me. Then he laughs. He says, "They treat prisoners better than they're treating you." Can you believe that? Who would have left my house? We're afraid to leave the house. It's almost like we're becoming a socialist communist government with this prime minister of ours. But I didn't go. I never saw my mother before I went there.
We can't get our kids to come here because they live in California.
Right.
Fly here. When they go home, they have to quarantine. And then the kids can go back to
school. You could fly from Toronto to Miami and you don't have to quarantine. Miami, into Canada.
Miami is something else.
Yeah.
Florida is something else.
Yeah. I felt like I had a half a life there because everybody wears their masks unless you watch what the kids are doing at South Beach, but you just don't go out of the areas you're not familiar with. You have to be careful wherever you go. Same thing here.
Right. Esther, our deep condolences on your loss.
Thank you. I just think to myself, I wonder what story she didn't tell us, you know? That's an end of an era.
Yep, and there's no one to ask anymore.
And there's nobody
just
to
gave my, I just gave my kids the Steven Spielberg copies of the tapes that I had from, you know, and they haven't seen it yet. It's a tearjerker.
I'd like to watch them. I gave them to my siblings. I watched them with my grandkids when they were going down the March of the Living, and I hadn't seen them since they did it, and I was stunned. You know, things that you forget.
Been a pleasure. Mike, you had a very successful evening. It was very nice.
Yeah, we had a lot of people on. We had close to 50 people tonight.
Bonnie, welcome. It was good to see you.
Yes. Yeah, I know. You doing okay, Bonnie?
Well.
Bonnie, you doing okay? I know.
I just got back from the hospital after 3 weeks.
Wow.
I smashed my wrist.
Well, we're glad you joined us again.
Well, I'm delighted. I love this program. Thank you. Thank you.
Are you a survivor, Bonnie? Or you lived in the United States?
No, I am probably old enough to be your parents. Yeah. I'm 90.
But your parents, you were born in the United States.
I was born here. My parents came from Russia and Poland. And my brother only spoke Yiddish. That's how I learned Yiddish.
Right. Yeah. Amazing. Wow. You should feel better.
Yeah.
Well, that's your condolences to you. That's so hard.
Akol b'seder, baruch Hashem, toda rabba.
Your husband's on the mend?
He is moving in the right direction.
That's wonderful.
Good. Well, you guys have been vaccinated. We've been vaccinated. Sounds like when he's ready, let's go have dinner, okay?
You're on. Oh my gosh, I'm going over to tell him that.
We started going out again now that everybody's vaccinated.
We were out Saturday night for the first time just before the symphony.
That's where people are going.
I can't wait for all of that.
Bye, everybody.
Bye. Good night.
Good night, everyone. We'll see you in two weeks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mike. Thank you.